My picture take of this way.
Kine muntale tu?
No, you take this.
Era. Okay. 1 minute.
See, I'll tell you the names. You point there.
Okay. So Francis Barneto is going to introduce us.
You put this
okay, thing. No, I'm not putting it anywhere. Yeah, okay. Okay. Come on now, just
no.
Start the names. So we'll go from that line till here.
Don.
So these are different Goan traditional pots, each of which has its own shape and its own name.
And its own purpose. Yes,
own
purpose.
Okay, so
that's a don.
Don for
to keep
pig.
Rice, no.
Okay.
To keep rice and any
raw rice. Then
that is a chamber pot.
Chamber pot. Called a unnel.
Yeah. This is called a
the third one.
Small sautel.
Sautel for
cook meat.
Cook meat. Why meat?
You need a wide mouth.
Okay. Then
this is a utility pot. This is a sanon compro.
A what?
Sanon compro.
Okay, it's a baking oven for sanas.
Yeah, it's a kind of oven.
Okay, it traps the heat.
Yeah, it traps heat.
Just so lift it up now, please.
You can steam.
Okay, careful, don't break it. We can't replace it. If you break it, it'll be considered sold. Don for?
Also, like that big one.
Okay.
It's a small
for
one.
For rice?
For rice, or for anything. This is a
gurgulet. Shame on you. I know it better than you. Okay, so the gurgulet keeps the water cool.
Yeah, and it's used for drinking water.
It keeps the water cooler than room temperature. How's that?
Yeah,
because it perspires.
The chill factor of the moisture that is outside.
Okay.
When the breeze blows, there's a chill factor that cools the water.
Next
is also the same.
Unnel. Urinal.
Oh, this is a porgo.
So the unnel collects the urine when people couldn't go out in the night.
Yeah.
For elders.
It's a chamber pot. It's kept under the bed.
For elders.
For elders, sick people.
Okay.
This is a porgo where rice water is kept and used. A kanji is kept.
Yeah.
And used.
Okay.
This is a kunle.
Kunle.
Right. Small one.
There may be different variations in the way it's pronounced in different parts of Goa. Then
this is a budkulo.
Budkulo for drawing water?
It could be used for keeping, storing water, drawing water.
By the way, Francis, budkulo is a name in the sense of budkule.
Budkule.
Budkule. And you know, I heard the most...
Now you're taping, your thing is on or what are you doing?
It is on. So, I heard the most unusual thing when, one guy told me that his name was...
Budkule.
No, Budkule is one
Batkule.
Name.
Budkule.
No, Budkule is a different name, but just a sec. Buyao. Buyao?
Yeah.
Buyao is a kind of a pot.
Yeah.
Right? And another pot is.
Budkulo.
Not Budkulo. There is another very name, very similar to Buyao. So,
the name. Burni.
Barne, which is Borni.
Yeah.
So then I asked him, are they related to you? Then he went into explanation which I didn't even expect, saying that no, it's not that we have named ourselves differently. Okay. Then?
That is also porgo.
Porgo then?
Small one.
For rice?
For rice water.
Then?
This is
by the way, if you're just joining us, Francis Barneto is explaining to me all the different kinds of pots which are being displayed here for the traditional Eastern Saligon. This is what?
This is a utility pot. You could put heat water, store anything on there.
Hey, come on, yeah. You can't just give it a name and English name and call it a utility something.
It has a name, but I'm not really sure.
Okay.
Okay, I'll show you.
I mean, this is like, there's a lot of science involved in this, no? I mean, even collecting the...
This is used for collecting rice water. The pot with rice, after it is boiled, a wooden piece is put here, and this is used to strain and drain rice water.
Both go together?
Yeah, and then this rice water is put into this, it's called a porgo.
Yeah.
And this is then used
kept for the full day?
For as long as, before it gets spoiled.
It will ferment at some stage. No?
Yeah, because so it is hard, it's used for
exactly.
Drinking.
Okay. These are kundles of different sizes?
Different sizes.
Any this different names?
Budkulo.
You know, Francis, I was telling you about this book I had come across.
This.
Sorry.
This is a water bottle where people used to tie a matting and take it
for what?
For work or wherever they went. They carried water in this.
Oh, gosh.
It's a water bottle.
Why that shape? Any reason?
It's a like in bottles you have what is known as a pumpkin seed flask.
Yeah.
So this is a kind of a flask.
Earthen version of it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. This has a name, but I can't remember the name.
Okay.
This is a unique thing.
And?
All of these are the repetition of the same.
Okay.
Gurgurai.
This is something new.
This is a makau ginger jar.
Ginger jar?
Yeah. And these little things here are used to tie down the cap.
Ginger jar for what?
The ginger preserve came in this. Ginger was considered a medicinal sweet. It was like
delicacy.
Delicacy. And that came in this.
I see.
And that is a don.
Don, again for rice.
Not only for rice, but storing anything, grain.
So they've got quite a collection of pots here, no?
Yeah, but they still have some missing.
No, what I was pointing out is that I had come across this book by someone called Agnello Pereira or Fernandez or something, Memories of My Homeland or something like that. And if I can interrupt, he had this listing of different Goan utensils, each with its own name and its own.
Yeah, that's what we want actually.
Yeah, but I lost that book and it's out of print.
Because I have almost all the types of pots with me. I don't have the real names.
So, Francis, tell us about your bottle museum, which is.
No, I've spoken about the bottle museum.
You've spoken at length elsewhere, but this is different. So, you have how many bottles with you as of now?
Maybe over 3,000.
3,000. 3,000?
Yes.
So, what is delaying the museum?
It'll happen. It's just that it's not been popularized.
Not been publicized and popularized. Okay, so that.
This is a very old popular toy called a chutti soro.
A very old?
Toy. To frighten people. It's called a chutti soro.
So it is made of the coconut palm frond and it's
an imitation of a snake. And there are. Take a bioita chutti sorop da.
So the memories remain, but the knowledge has not been captured or put down. Thank you so much for introducing us to all these different pots and pans. Now, thank you.